Hello everyone and welcome back to ZakLiT educational channel. So this video we are going to know the answer key for the JK set 2022 environmental science paper, which will be equally important for the UGC net environmental science exam or any other set or environmental science related examination. So this is a rapid revision in which we will know the correct answers. So get ready with your notes so that you can write down the important points which we are going to discuss in this video. So let's start today's video. So first question number 31 we will be solving. This paper is already uploaded in our Telegram channel. You can search JK set and you will get in the file section. So question 31 says, criteria of successful long-term conservation depends on what? So I'll wait for certain seconds. You people should read all the options, then I'll reveal the correct option. So here the correct option will be option number D, integration of diversity of genetic species and ecosystem including their interaction and ecological process. All this integration will prove as a successful long-term conservation. So here option D will be correct. So here I would like to say that if you have given the previous year's questions and you are coming up with the examination, you should have marked that most of the time I am telling the longest option will be the correct option. So this thing you should mark, even if you don't know, then if you can guess that, if the longest option given in the question will be the correct option. So this is the simple tip I am giving you. It is not every time correct, but most of the time it is correct. Coming to the next question, question 32, Shannon-Wiener index measures what? So this is also very, very important related to the ecology and ecosystem. So here option C will be correct, that is Shannon-Wiener index measures the diversity of species, or species diversity we can say. What is species diversity? It includes both species richness and species evenness. This thing also you should note down. Species diversity means species richness plus species evenness, and it is also only called as Shannon's index. So this is Shannon-Wiener index or Shannon's index we can call. Let's move to the next question. Next question number 36 on the right hand side. The most suitable material for moderator in nuclear reactor is what? So here the options are given: D2O, cadmium, boron and uranium. So here correct option will be D2O. What is D2O? D2O is actually heavy water which is used as the moderator in nuclear reactor, and other moderators used in nuclear reactor you should also note down, that is normal water which is H2O, and beryllium is also used here as a moderator in nuclear reactor. Similarly, graphite is also used. Graphite is what? It is form of carbon. So these four things are important: water, heavy water, that is D2O, and graphite and beryllium. These are used as moderator in nuclear reactor. So guys, before going ahead, let me remind about the four mock test series for the UGC NET Environmental Science 2022 examination, which will consist of 400 questions and give you a solid revision for the examination. You just need to follow two steps. First, you have to pay a nominal amount of rupees 99 through Google Pay or Phone Pay to this number 8895035690. Then send me the screenshot of this payment and I will provide you the links which you can attempt at your any convenient time. Next question is, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, that is Clean India Mission, is a countrywide campaign initiated by Government of India in which of the following years? And here all of you should be knowing that. So it will be 2014 in which this campaign was launched. More specifically on 2nd of October 2014, that is the Gandhi Jayanti date in 2014. Coming to the next set of questions, here question number 33 will go in the left hand side. The ultimate stable and culminating community during succession is called as what community? So here culminating, some of you will be confused. Culminate means to reach a climax or point of highest development. So highest development point or climax, it is already telling about the culminating. So climax community will be the answer. Here you should also know the initial stage, the initial starting members of any succession, they are called as pioneer community, and finally they are called as climax community. They are stable and they are culminating community. Coming to the next question, question number 34, the pioneer female, again pioneer means the starting, the initial stage, the female activist of CIPCO movement in India was whom? So she was none other than our Amrita Devi Bishnoi ji. Option B will be correct. So shears from the Bishnoi community and this Chipko movement was initially started in 1730s where in Rajasthan Jodhpur region. This thing also you should note down. Some of the time they will be asking you. So this was started in the Jodhpur, Rajasthan. Coming to the next question, question 38. Select the wrong statement for electromagnetic wave. So here we have to identify which statement is incorrect regarding the electromagnetic wave. We'll read one by one. First is electromagnetic waves are transverse in nature. It is correct. They travel with same speed in all medium. This is incorrect. Yes, in different medium, the electromagnetic wave will behave differently, will have different speed, but they travel with the speed of light approximately close to the light speed and they are produced by accelerating charge. So these three are correct, but B is incorrect. So we have to find incorrect wrong statement. So option B will be the correct option for this question. Coming to the next question, question number 35, left hand side. On our screen, the pioneer human community and human evolution is what? Again, pioneer one question. Pioneer means initially during the human evolution, who came first in the human community? So they were none other than nomads. Yes, nomads were the pioneer community in the human evolution, followed by hunter and gatherer, that is hunting and gathering society, followed by agro society, then now the industrial society. So this sequence also you should note down. Nomads, hunter-gatherer, agro-society and industrial society. Coming to the next question, question 39 on right hand side. The maximum permissible limit of biochemical oxygen demand, that is BOD, in milligram per liter in a treated wastewater that is discharged into the river should be of how much concentration? So this answer should be option number D. Yes, maximum permissible limit will be 30 milligram per liter. But if it is asking, if it is discharged into the sewer or in the sewerage system, then it should be how much? It should be 100 milligram per liter. But as here it was asking into the river or any water bodies which is fresh, so it should be 30 milligram per liter. Option D will be correct. So I hope you are noting down all these things. Let's move to the question 40. Which of the following is neutron absorber? Kaun neutron ko absorb karta hai? Question 40, very, very important. This will be option number C, cadmium. Cadmium is a neutron absorber. Along with that, who else are neutron absorber? They are graphite, which we have discussed in the nuclear reactor. Graphite, beryllium, and boron. So these four things you should note down. Boron, beryllium, graphite, and cadmium, they are the neutron absorber. Coming to the next set of questions. Question number 41, assertion and reasoning question. This assertion and reasoning is very, very simple. Chocolate question, I will say. Assertion statement states, sustainable development is necessary for the survival of human race. It is absolutely correct. Reason states, rapid economic growth without environmental concerns cannot be sustained. This is also correct. And this is also giving the correct explanation of assertion statement. That means if you are going for the sustainable development is what? It means you should do development as well as we should have the environmental concern and we should preserve our resources for the future generation. So both assertion and reasoning are correct and reason is the correct explanation of assertion statement. So I hope you have noting down as I am repeatedly saying. Question 42. The year of Chernobyl disaster was what? This is also one of the frequent asked question. In which year Chernobyl disaster took place? In the year 1986, to be specific, 26th of April 1986, where it took place? It took place in Chernobyl, that is in Ukraine. It was a nuclear accident. The reactor building, it was demolished, it collapsed and radiation was released into the atmosphere, resulting in so much of life losses. Coming to the next question, question 43, again assertion and reasoning. So we'll read here. The assertion statement states aluminum chloride is a good coagulant for the treatment of raw water. Yes, it is correct. Aluminum chloride is used as a coagulant for the water treatment. Reason states both the colloidal particles and the aluminum ions are positively charged. This is not correct statement because the aluminum is actually the aluminum ions, they are having the positive charge. And the colloids are having the negative charges. So because of that, aluminium is surrounding the colloids and they form a mass. And as a result, this bonding is removed. So as a result, the water is treated. So negative charge and positive charge, they make a combination. As a result, they are removed. The coagulation is removed. So I hope you are able to understand this thing. Let's move to the next question. Next question number 44 will come on the right hand side. Mic stands for what? This is not mic in which we used to give speeches or sing song. This mic is monitoring of illegal killing of elephants, or monitoring the illegal killing of elephants will be also correct. So option A will be correct. We should know a little bit more about this. What is this? This monitoring was launched in the year 2003, and this was launched by CITES, that is CITES. This full form also you should note down. That is what? Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of what? Wild Fauna and Flora. So this was signed in the year when the CITES was signed. It was signed in the year 1973. I am not talking about Mike. Now I am talking about CITES. So CITES was signed in the year 1973. It came into effective in 1975. So 3 years you should remember. Mike was in the year, it was launched in the year 2003, and it was launched by the CITES. CITES was launched in 1973, but it came into effective in 1975. So I hope you have noted down, all these years are also important. Coming to question number 45, right hand side, regarding carbon credits. The question is asking, regarding carbon credits, which one of the following statements is not correct? So we'll read one by one and we will note down what are the correct statements regarding the carbon credits. Number one, the carbon credit system was ratified in the conjunction with the Kyoto Protocol. Absolutely correct. Carbon credits are awarded to countries or groups that have reduced greenhouse gases below their emission quota. It is also a correct statement. The goal of carbon credit system is to limit the increase of carbon emission quota. That is also correct. So one is left. Obviously, it will be not correct. So no need to go for this statement. It is telling carbon credits are traded at a price fixed from time to time by the UNEP. It is not correct. And to know more about carbon credit, I will be putting a chart related to carbon credits. So note, I will be putting in our Telegram group. If you haven't joined our Telegram group, you can join. The link is in the description for the regular quizzes, daily quizzes and important notes. So here option D will be the not correct statement. So we'll get option D as correct for this question. Coming to the next question. Next question is question 46, gas chromatography. Gas chromatography is applied for the analysis of what kind of compounds? It is used for analyzing the volatile compounds. Yes, volatile means which are easily vaporized or readily vaporized. They are volatile compounds. So that is with the help of gas chromatography, we do their analysis. Coming to question 47, protein content is high in the wastewater from following industry. This is a basic question which you should use your intelligence from paper and pulp industry or chemical industry or leather or dairy industry. So it will be dairy industry, because dairy means related to milk, and milk is highly rich in protein. So protein content will be high in the wastewater from the dairy industry. Simple thing, basic common sense. Let's move to the next set of questions. Next question number 48 on our left hand side. Question 48 is, there is concern over the increase in harmful algal blooms in the sea waters of India. What could be the causative factor of this phenomenon? So why algae are seen in the sea waters of India, high algal bloom? Because of discharge of nutrients from the estuaries. Yes, correct, because nutrient rich means there will be algal bloom. Next is runoff from the land during the monsoon. Yes, from land they will be carrying the nutrients, again it will cause the algal bloom. Upwelling in the seas. Yes, some of you will not be knowing upwelling in the seas. What is that thing? Upwelling means when the bottom of the sea water, it will come to the top part, it will cause the upwelling of the sea. So up, moving of the upward direction, moving of the below water or groundwater. So these things, they will be carrying, they are rich in nutrient, so they are pushed to the upward surface of the seas. As a result, the upward surface is rich in nutrient now, and the algae are growing. So because of that, algal bloom also take place. So upwelling in the seas also is one of the reasons. So here option D will be correct. That is 1, 2 and 3 all are the causative factor for this phenomena, that is algal bloom. I hope you have understood. If you can't, then you can comment in the comment section. I will let you understand. Question number 50 on your screen right hand side. Due to improper or indiscriminate disposal of old and used computer and their parts, which of the following are released in the environment as e-waste? E-waste means electronic waste. So here it is specifically asking about the computers and their part disposal. So I'll let you know which 2 or 3 or 1 will be not considered in the e-waste. Number 1 is heptachlor. Heptachlor is actually the thing which is a termite control chemical. So this is not included in the e-waste. Similarly, plutonium. Plutonium will also not come. So because plutonium is used as the power source for satellite, you should note down, or in the atomic bombs or nuclear weapons it is used, so it cannot be found in the e-waste. But beryllium, cadmium, chromium, mercury and lead, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, all can be found in the e-waste from the computer and its parts. So which will be the correct option? The correct option will be where it will be not 4 and 7, that means option number B. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 4 and 7 not, because heptachlor is a material for termite control and 7 plutonium is the power source for satellite or atomic bombs, nuclear weapons. Next, coming to the next question, question number 49 on the left hand side, the acidification of ocean. So let me highlight this. The acidification of ocean is increasing. Why is this phenomena a cause of concern? Number one, the growth and survival of calcareous phytoplankton will be adversely affected. It is also correct, because as the acidification of ocean acidifies, the calcareous cell, they cannot survive. As a result, they will die. Next is the growth and survival of coral reef will be affected. It is also correct thing. So it is a matter of concern. Next is survival of some animals that have phytoplanktonic larvae will be adversely affected, because phytoplanktons will be affected. As a result, animals which are relying on those, they will be also affected. It is also a cause of concern. Next is the cloud seeding and formation of cloud will be also affected. So whether this is true, whether this is a cause of concern? Yes, it is a cause of concern from the acidification of ocean. Why? I will let you know. First of all, what happens is the phytoplanktons, they are releasing dimethyl sulfide, that is DMS, phytoplanktons in the oceans, in the sea, DMS, dimethyl sulfide. This dimethyl sulfide, it reacts in atmosphere to form H2SO4 and it attaches to the aerosol in the atmosphere. So this aerosol, then again after several chemical reactions, they used to form the cloud. So they seed the cloud formation. So indirectly the phytoplanktons are giving the help for the cloud formation. So if they are affected, then cloud seeding and the formation of cloud will be also affected. So option 4 will be also, the point 4 will be also a cause of concern if ocean acidification increases. So here all the four statements are the cause of concern, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, option D will be correct. I think for some of you it will be new concept. If it is new for you, note down this. Coming to question 51, which ancient Indian text contains rules and regulation on protection of forest and Abhayaranya? So here this rule is given by Kautilya's Arthashastra, option B will be correct, which says about the protection of forest and Abhayaranya. So these were the questions till 51. After that we have already solved. You can check the link in the I button. So here we will meet you in the next video. Till then, keep smiling and believe in yourself. Don't forget to subscribe the channel ZakLiT for further updates.